JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for October the 26th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against most of the other major currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It underperformed only versus AUD and slightly against NZD, while it gained the most versus the euro and versus the Swiss franc and the euro in that order. Now, the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie and Kiwi combined with the weakening of the safe haven franc suggests that the market participants may have continued to add to their risk exposures yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, most major European and US indices finished their sessions in positive territory, with the exceptions being Euro Stoxx 50, which traded virtually unchanged, and France's CAC, which slid somewhat. In the US, both the Dow Jones and the S&P 500 hit fresh record highs. Now, today in Asia, Nikkei and KOSPI followed suit and inched higher, but China Shanghai Composite and Hong Kong's Hang Seng declined after China said that it will roll out a pilot real estate tax in some regions, adding to concerns with regards to the property sector and the nation's overall economic performance. Now, with no fresh catalysts to drive the markets yesterday, we believe that investors remained willing to take more risk as quarter three earnings continued to come in generally better than expected. Yesterday, Tesla rose 4.5% after Hertz ordered 100,000 of its electric cars, providing the biggest boost to the S&P 500 and the Nasdaq, followed by PayPal, which abandoned plans to buy Pinterest for as much as $45 billion. During after hours, Facebook reported better earnings but missed the revenue forecast. Now, with a couple of more tech giants, Amazon and Apple, reporting their results today, and with no major data on the economic agenda, market participants may stay focused on equities and upcoming earnings reports, where more decent announcements could help stock indices to continue conquering new highs, as this could mean that the latest supply shortages did not affect the global economy, as many may have believed. Now, despite the broader risk appetite, the US dollar managed to outperform most of its peers yesterday, suggesting a disconnection from the broader market sentiment. Remember that in the recent past, the greenback has been acting as a safe haven currency, strengthening when participants were cautious and weakening during periods of market euphoria. In our view, with data and earnings suggesting that the US economy was not affected by the latest bottlenecks, as many may have believed, investors considered the case of a tapering at next week's Fed gathering a done deal, and may have also brought forth their expectations with regards to when the first rate increase could take place. That's probably why they were willing to buy even more US dollars. According to the Fed Fat Futures, they now anticipated 25 basis points hike to be delivered in October 2022. Remember that a few weeks ago, such a move was priced in for the first months of 2023. At this point, though, we have to note that a lot on that front may depend on the first estimate of the US GDP for the third quarter, due to be released on Thursday. Now, as for today's events, as yesterday, the economic calendar remains light today as well. The only relatively important data we get are the US Conference Board Consumer Confidence Index for October and the new home sales for September. The CB index is expected to have slid fractionally, but new home sales are forecast to have increased somewhat. Now, tonight, during the Asian session Wednesday, we have New Zealand's trade balance for September and Australia's CPIs for the third quarter. No forecasts available for New Zealand's trade balance, while Australia's CPI is expected to have slowed to 3.1% year-over-year from 3.8%. Both the trimmed mean and weighted mean rates are forecast to have inched slightly higher, but to have remained below the lower end of the RBA's target range of 2 to 3%. So this is likely to add credence to the RBA's view that interest rates are unlikely to start rising before 2024, despite market participants seeing the official cash rate hitting 0.50% by the end of next year, at least according to the ASX 30-day interbank cash rate futures yield curve. As for the Aussie, slowing inflation could result in some selling, but bearing in mind that the currency is mostly driven by developments surrounding the broader market sentiment, we don't expect a major trend reversal. As long as investors remain generally optimistic, the risk-linked currency could stay in an uptrend mode. Any CPI-related retreat could be just a temporary correction. Now, as for the speakers, today we will get to hear from ECB Supervisory Board Chair Andrea Enria. So, that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.